Good day to Dinarans on the go and in the know, October 26, 2019, no hype, no BS, just the facts. Hit the like and subscribe button so you don't miss out on my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert, and know that today, we are one day closer than yesterday. First article of interest, Jaburi commented on the burning of his house, October 26, 2019 017 Baghdad. Protesters broke into the house of the head of the Parliamentary Finance Committee Haitham al-Jaburi in the province of Babylon, and set it on fire. Thank you to the demonstrators who burned my house, he said. This house was serving them all their needs, he said. Next article of interest. Qatar's, what is happening in Iraq is major human rights violations. October 25, 2019 16-8-19. UN Secretary General Antonio Guterres on Friday condemned the gross violations by human rights forces in Iraq, saying according to our first conclusions, there are certain to be major human rights violations that must be clearly condemned without further details. The death toll among protesters rose to 30 on Friday in Iraq, including 8 in Baghdad, the Iraqi Human Rights Commission said in a statement. Half of them were shot dead in the south of the country, where demonstrators tried to storm a headquarters of the Saib al-Haq, one of the most prominent factions of the popular mobilization forces. Among the dead were three in the southern oil city of Basra, which saw a similar week of violence last year. Demonstrators set fire to the buildings of the provinces of Dhekar and Diwaniya, and burned more than a dozen headquarters of political parties in the south of the country, according to security sources. Security forces repelled a barrage of tear gas on Friday by thousands of demonstrators gathered in central Baghdad. All security forces have been on alert since Thursday evening by Adel Abdel Mahdi government, which on Friday completed its first year in office. This prompted demonstrators to return to the symbolic Tahrir Square, which is separated from the Green Zone by the Republic Bridge. This came after the representative of Ayatollah Ali al-Sistani, the highest Shiite authority in Iraq, called in Friday's sermon for restraint to avoid chaos. He added that the religious authority emphasis on the need for peaceful protests to be free from violence stems from its keenness on the future of this country and fears with it that the violence and the corresponding violence will descend into chaos and devastation between some international and regional powers. The security forces dispersed with water cannons on Friday night demonstrators at the entrance to the Green Zone. The cheers of the demonstrators were unified, all thieves, calling for the overthrow of the government, in an oil-rich country but suffering from chronic power shortages and drinking water. The dispersal came hours before the planned mobilization of supporters of Shiite cleric Muqtada al-Sadr, who put all his weight in the balance of the protest movement. Next article of interest. Unearthed sniper elements targeting protesters and security men to ignite sedition in favor of Iranian men. Friday, October 25, 2019 Baghdad, writings. Iraqi demonstrators said they saw a third party fueling the conflict between the Iraqi army and security forces on the one hand and protesters on the other. According to what was circulated, masked elements seized some buildings near the sites of demonstrations in a number of provinces, including the capital Baghdad, and continued to target demonstrators with live bullets and also targeted security elements. October to preserve the gains of Iranian men from the wealth of Iraq. This explains why the death toll among protesters rose to 23 inches less than 7 hours Friday. Next article of interest. Calls for international intervention to protect Iraqis from Iran's armed militia and its arms in government. Saturday, October 26, 2019 Baghdad writings. Demonstrators in Iraq called on the international community to intervene urgently to protect the Iraqi people from the systematic killing and liquidation carried out by the Iranian militia in the country in cooperation with some security elements of the government of Prime Minister Adel Abdul Mahdi. Demonstrators called on the international community to act to protect them from the militia and government killing machine that killed more than 31 Iraqis and injured hundreds during the uprising, in which they declared their rejection of the current government and Iran's domination of Iraqi wealth during protests since the early hours of October 25, 2019. The demonstrators shouted strongly against Iran's supreme leader Ali Khamenei in Karbala and tore up his pictures in the holy city of the Shiite component. Next article of interest. The Iraqi judiciary prevents those accused of corruption cases from traveling. 26 October, 2019. The Supreme Judicial Council decided on Friday to arrest those accused of financial and administrative corruption cases and prevent them from traveling abroad. The council said in a statement today that in light of the events and after the electronic deliberation and the emergency meeting between the president of the Supreme Judicial Council with members of the Supreme Judicial Council has reached the council to instruct the Central Court Against Corruption to take extraordinary measures to issue arrest warrants for the defendants within their jurisdiction. The court prohibits their travel and instructs the executive bodies to do so. The council declared that Article 2, Paragraph 2, of the anti-terrorism law in force stipulates that it is considered to be a terrorist act acts of violence and threats to deliberately demolish, destroy or damage buildings or public property, government interests, government institutions, bodies, state departments, the private sector or facilities. Any person who assaulted firearms against army, police or security services or assaulted national military units is considered a terrorist act under Article 2. Paragraph 5, and that such crimes are punishable by death under the anti-terrorism law. Next article of interest, the judiciary confirms the right to peaceful demonstration and sends a message to the security forces. October 26, 2019-96, the Supreme Judicial Council, Saturday, the right of peaceful demonstration guaranteed under the Constitution, a statement of the judiciary, received Euphrates News a copy of it. The Supreme Judicial Council affirms the right of peaceful demonstration guaranteed under the Constitution. Al-Qasa called on the security services to exercise their duty to defend peaceful demonstrators and not to attack them from any side and to protect public and private properties and party headquarters. Next article of interest. Improve people's lives does not need a magic wand. 20th October, 2019 by Mohammed Abdul-Jabbar Karp. People revolt because of poverty, hunger, corruption, injustice, etc. They revolt in order to improve their living conditions and lives, and often the central link is that they have access to honest jobs, sufficient income and good services. These are all things that can be provided with varying degrees of ease or difficulty, depending on the country's resources and the ability of its people to work. The quality of life can be improved without the need for a magic wand in the hands of the ruler or administrator. Say this about practical experience. Work to increase the salaries of the staff of the media network when I took over, taking advantage of the legal tools that were available then, including the financial capacity of the state. Did not need a magic wand, but a legal article in force. The people in this revolution against hunger, poverty, crime and corruption are absolutely right and cannot and should not be blamed for this. They are waiting for the existing and ruling authorities in their country to do something to satisfy them, remove injustice and injustice from them, and fight the corruption that impoverished them and discriminated against them. Had the authorities failed to do so, people revolt not only against hunger, but also against the authorities. There is a sound of the popular slogan, people want to overthrow the regime, but for this slogan to be feasible, the people must know the alternative system that can actually improve their standard of living. Otherwise it is not reasonable for a person to demolish a house without equipping the alternative house. The human experience has shown that the best of human life is to be improved in a modern civilized state because this formula guarantees the protection of human dignity and the protection of human dignity, without injustice, discrimination or corruption. On October 1st, young men and boys took to the streets because they realized they were facing an uncertain future and suffered a bitter present. They have the freedom to demonstrate and protest, and they resorted to using this legal right to claim their natural rights. They have no other choice. But what we have to focus on now is that demonstrations and protests should be for life, not for death, for victory, not for martyrdom, for a modern civilized state capable of improving human life and not for a state that reproduces tyranny, backwardness, dictatorship and corruption, injustice and confiscation of freedoms. His is not possible under a rudimentary, backward, corrupt, undemocratic and uncivilized political class. Hence, the long-term strategic goal of social mobility should be to establish the modern civilized state, the general framework for achieving all other political, social, economic and service objectives. We may see this goal away or difficult. His is true. It is not an easy target near, but it is not impossible, and certainly does not need a magic wand. Next article of interest, and I would like to mention before I read this, remember, never let a good crisis go to waste. It's how the elites work, taking advantage of a good crisis to move forward with an agenda. Guterres urges world leaders to listen to protesters' issues. UN chief tells reporters there is a growing threat to public order because of trust deficit between leaders and people. Guterres said people want their human rights respected, including the right to have a say in the decision-making process. File, Carlo Allegri. Reuters. Antonio Guterres, the Secretary General of the United Nations, has called on protesters around the world to commit to nonviolence as they seek change while urging world leaders to listen to the real problems of real people. The UN chief told reporters on Friday that disquiet in people's lives has sparked protests around the world from the Middle East to Europe, Africa, Asia, Latin America and the Caribbean. It is clear that there is a growing deficit of trust between people and political establishments, and rising threats to the social contract, he said. The world is also wrestling with the negative impacts of globalization and new technologies, which have increased inequalities within societies. Then where people are not protesting, they are hurting and want to be heard. Guterres said people want their human rights respected, including the right to have a say in the decision-making process. People want a level playing field, including social, economic and financial systems that work for all. The Secretary General reiterated his deep concern that some protests have turned violent and led to the loss of life, stressing that governments are obligated to uphold freedom of expression and assembly and security forces must act with maximum restraint, in conformity with international law. There can be no excuse for violence, from any quarter, he said. In response to a question about deadly protests in Iraq, Guterres said the UN has been systematically appealing for non-violence and for restraint by Iraqi authorities and other actors. He pointed to recent UN preliminary findings which showed substantial violations of human rights that took place and need to be clearly denounced and condemned. As for protests in Lebanon, he said, his message is that the country must solve its problems with dialogue. I urge maximum restraint and no use of violence, both from the side of the government and the side of the protesters, he said. More articles of interest to come. Hit that subscribe button and the alert bell so you don't miss my next post. I encourage you, knowledge is power, stay informed and stay alert. Over and out for now, the Dinarion.